Internet of Things, IoT, is an ecosystem of devices that connect to and communicate via the Internet. A typical IoT deployment consists of embedded devices or sensors with network connectivity to collect and exchange data. Communication over an IP network between the sensors and the cloud servers, and the cloud services such as analytics or machine learning on the cloud servers. NetSim can be used to simulate the communication over the network. NetSim's IoT network stack comprises of application layer, sensor application as well as applications such as COAP, voice, video, etc. Transport layer, UDP. Network layer, AODV and RPL routing protocols. And MAC and PHY layers, 802.15.4 ZigBee. The various devices supported in NetSim's IoT module include wireless sensors in which the sensing part is abstract and NetSim simulates the radio communication. This means the sensors used could be any kind of sensing or embedded device. 6. Low-pan gateway helps to bridge the internal network of sensors with the external internet. Routers to connect to the cloud. Switches to act as the connecting devices to interconnect with the server. And wired nodes which simulate the cloud servers. Let me quickly show how to create a simple IoT network in NetSim. Select Internet of Things from the NetSim home screen. A fast config window appears that allows users to define device placement strategies and conveniently model large network scenarios, especially in networks such as MANET, WSN, and IoT. The grid length represents the area of simulation environment. The side length represents the sub-grid area within which the sensor devices will be placed automatically. Device placement provides the users with the options for different auto placements like uniform placement, random placement, and file-based placement. You can specify the number of devices that need to be auto-placed in the sensor grid. In our case, we create a network with 16 sensors uniformly placed. This is the NetSim design window. On the top we can see the ribbon, which consists of various categories of devices specific to the IoT network module of NetSim. Below is the grid environment where we will design and configure our IoT network. We will now place a 6 low-pan gateway followed by a router and then a wired node. Connect the sensors to the 6 low-pan gateway. All the sensors and the gateway are now interconnected with each other in an ad hoc basis. This provides an infrastructure-less connectivity among the sensors and the gateway device. The ad hoc link icon is a representation of this connectivity. Users can configure the ad hoc link by right-click and selecting Properties option. Users can set different channel models for path loss, shadowing and fading. Now we connect gateway and the router, followed by the wired node using wired wireless links option. Having designed a simple IoT network, the next step is to configure these devices. Open Properties of Wireless Sensor 1. In the General Properties, you can specify the sensor positions and set mobility to the sensor devices. The different mobility models supported are Random Walk, Random Waypoint, and Group Mobility. In the Application layer, you have an option for configuring SDN in the event users seek to run SDN-based IoT simulations. The transport layer runs UDP protocol. The two routing protocols supported at the network layer are AODV and RPL. In the ZigBee interface, PHY and MAC layers support IEEE 802.15.4 protocol. In the network layer, users can find the IPv6 addressing for the sensor modules. Similarly, Open 6 low-pan gateway properties. User can find two interfaces, a ZigBee interface for the sensor part and a WAN interface that connects to the cloud. In the ZigBee interface data link layer, users can either enable or disable beacon mode for packet transmission. In beacon enabled mode, nodes use slotted CSMACA algorithm for transmitting packets. Like we had configured the ad hoc link, we can configure the wired links too. The next logical step is to configure the application between the devices. Click on the application icon present in the top ribbon. By default, it selects the sensor application, set the source ID and the destination ID respectively. We will configure source ID as 2, a sensor, and destination ID as 19, a wired node. The application flow arrow represents data transmission from the sensor to the cloud server. User can also see that the default packet size is set to 50 bytes and the inter-packet arrival time set to 100,000 microseconds. User can add more applications by clicking on the plus symbol on the top left. Let's simulate this network. Enable plots. Enable packet trace. Now run the simulation. The simulation time is set to 100 seconds by default. NetSim console opens, displaying simulation progress. On completion, the results dashboard and animation window are displayed. This is the animation window. Play the animation. Initially AODVREQ packets are exchanged between all the sensors. After which AODVREP packet is sent. Following which data is sent from the sensor to the server via the 6 low-pan gateway, and for each data packet, a ZigBee acknowledgement is sent back. If we see the results dashboard, we can see the application throughput plots and link throughput plots organized neatly. The application metrics gives the throughput seen by the configured application, while the link metrics gives the details of link-wise and overall packet transmissions. In addition to it, on the left panel, users can see additional network-specific metrics like 802.15.4 metrics, battery model metrics and AODV metrics. Open packet trace. This will open a large Excel file having detailed packet flow information. Apply filters to the packet type as sensing and drag towards the last columns. User can find both the IPv6 and IPv4 addresses, which shows packet flow between the sensors and the cloud server. In addition to this, in the standard and pro versions of NetSim, users have the access to the protocol source C codes, which can be accessed from the NetSim GUI itself. The recommended IDE for this is Visual Studio 2019 Community Edition. Navigate to the NetSim design window, and from the help menu select open source code. The entire set of protocol source codes will be loaded. NetSim also has a GitHub repository which contains R&D project codes. In IoT, we have projects related to energy harvesting, various attacks and countermeasures. We also have a dedicated help desk where users can contact us regarding technical issues. We also have an extensive knowledge base consisting of more than 400 plus articles neatly categorized for the users to choose from. Please visit our new release page for the latest updates about NetSim. Thank you for watching.